Tatham Engineering is pleased to present on behalf of the City of North Bay the first public information center for the Schedule C Class Environmental Assessment for the Lakeshore Drive and Pinewood Park Drive improvements. This presentation will establish the channels of communication with the public and the key stakeholders, explain the study area, study purpose, and the objectives of the study, present the needs and justification for the study, and discuss the issues that need to be resolved, identify alternative solutions and the environmental impacts for each alternative. We'd also like to seek input and comment for consideration in the selection of the final preferred solution. We ask the public and the stakeholders to review the presentation materials, ask questions to the consultant, and to submit a comment and indicate whether you'd like to be kept informed throughout the process. The objectives of the study are to improve traffic operations on Lakeshore Drive, improve traffic operation on Pinewood Park Drive, improve traffic operations at the intersection of Highway 11, Lakeshore Drive, and Pinewood Park Drive, improve traffic operations at all other intersections within the study area, implement active transportation throughout the study area, provide traffic operations for future development throughout the study area. The purpose of the study is to develop alternative solutions to improve traffic operations, identify sensitive environments, assess the alternatives and their associated impacts, identify the preferred solution, establish measures to mitigate the adverse impacts, and finally satisfy the requirements of the Class EA study. The Class EA schedules are determined by the type of work being undertaken, the potential impacts of the work, and the dollar value of the work. Given the scope of our project, it falls under a Schedule C. To satisfy the Class EA process, we will need to follow the five phases as shown in the flow chart in the slide. We are currently in Phase 2 at the first Public Information Center. Throughout the process, there are opportunities for public review and input through notices, public information centers, and a 30-day review of the final report and findings. The study area is outlined in orange on the slide. It starts on Lakeshore Drive at Ferris Drive and continues east to Pinewood Park, then turns south and heads along Pinewood Park till approximately 1 kilometer south of Decaire Road. The length of the study area is approximately 3.7 kilometers. There are four key intersections within the study area, which are depicted by the red circles on the slide. Lakeshore Drive is a primary arterial road, which purpose is to accommodate high traffic volumes and provide a through travel route. The cross section is currently two lanes and varies between a rural section with open ditches and a semi-urban section with curb and gutter. Between Booth Road and the Kate Paceway, there is a multi-use trail on the south side. There's asphalt sidewalk everywhere else. Pinewood Park Drive is also a primary arterial road, which again, the purpose of the road is to accommodate high traffic volumes and to provide a through travel route. Pinewood Park is currently two lanes and is a rural section for the entire length with open ditches along both sides. There's currently no active transportation along the route. The future needs for the study area are as follows. Improve the road to meet city standards, ensure appropriate traffic operation for the future volumes, and ensure that multimodal transportation such as bike lanes, multi-use paths, and transit are integrated into the preferred solution. The problem statement that will guide the Class EA is that the influences of development and growth along the Lakeshore Drive and Pinewood Park Drive arterial road corridors has resulted in higher traffic volumes and traffic congestion, a trend which will continue. Opportunities for road and intersection improvements in these corridors needs to be evaluated, which also affords opportunity for implementing policies of the city's active transportation master plan. To address the future needs of the study area, we have considered the following alternatives. Alternative A is to do nothing and maintain the existing condition with no improvements. Alternative B is to reduce travel demand to a level where the road improvements are not needed. This can be done through other travel modes and shifting peak hour demands. Alternative C is to propose alternative travel routes by promoting use of other roads to reduce the demand on Lakeshore Drive and Pinewood Park Drive. Alternative D is to implement operational improvements such as reconstruction of the road and introducing improvements at key intersections. Pre-screening alternatives A through D, we have found that none of the alternatives fully address the need for the improved traffic operation and do not provide a long-term solution. To meet the future traffic demands along Lakeshore and Pinewood Park Drive, we need to develop alternatives that look at increasing road capacity through widening. Alternative E is to widen Lakeshore Drive and Pinewood Park Drive to three lanes. This would mean two travel lanes in each direction and one continuous center left turn lane. Alternative F is to widen both roads to four lanes. And finally, alternative G would be to widen both roads to five lanes, which would include two travel lanes in each direction and a continuous left turn lane. Pre-screening alternatives E through G, we discovered that alternative E would improve operations, but only slightly, and will not provide a long-term solution. Therefore, alternative F and G are the only alternatives that fulfill the problem statement and will be carried forward to the evaluation stage to be further studied. A study of the natural environment was completed through the study area by Fry Corps Ecological Services. The study area is mainly rural residential and commercial lands. There are 8 water crossings within the study area. The 2 major water courses are the Lavasse River and Cooks Creek. There are no provincially significant wetlands within the study area. The main impact we see to the natural environment will be the replacement or extension of existing water crossing culverts. Given the nature of the area and the minimal right-of-way widening that is required, we see the environmental impacts to be minimal. There will be no negative impact to any provincially significant wetland, natural, or conservation area. There will be minor loss of habitat and vegetation due to the widening of the road, which is typical in these types of projects. A cultural heritage evaluation completed by AMEC Consultants found that the land uses throughout the study area are mainly commercial, rural residential, and institutional. Most of the houses are set back from the edge of roadway, and the existing right-of-way width is generally greater than the 30-meter city standard. Therefore, there are only minor social environmental implications associated with the minor property takings to achieve the 30-meter right-of-way. AMIC also completed a Stage 1 archaeological heritage assessment and found that there's a low potential for significant prehistoric archaeological resources in the area of the existing road and existing developments. There's a higher potential in the areas where they're near navigable waters, like the Lavasse River, and near recorded archaeological sites and early settlement areas. The proposed road improvements are clear of any archaeological or heritage impact concerns. Alternative F and G for Lakeshore Drive has been assessed and summarized in the table on the slide. The items that have been highlighted through the evaluation are both 4 and 5 lane cross sections will accommodate the future travel demands along Lakeshore Drive. Natural environment impacts will be minimal for both alternatives. Due to the narrower road platform of alternative F, the impacts will be slightly less than alternative G. Property impacts for both alternatives will be the same since the city will be implementing a 30-meter right-of-way. Due to alternative F's slightly narrower road platform, there will be more opportunities for active transportation. There is no known cultural, heritage, or archaeological impacts for either of the alternatives. Alternative F will be less expensive to construct because of the narrower road platform and fewer hydropole impacts. Alternative F will also be able to be implemented on the bridge over the Lavasse River without major modifications to the structure. The recommended alternative for Lakeshore Drive is a 4-lane cross-section which will provide road capacity for future condition while minimizing the impacts along the study corridor. Alternatives F and G for Pinewood Park Drive have been evaluated and are summarized in the table on the slide. Some of the key items that were noted through the evaluation are a 4-lane cross-section will accommodate the future traffic demands. However, development along Pinewood Park Drive is going to continue. Therefore, implementing a 5-lane cross-section with a center left turn lane will prolong the capacity of the road. Natural environment impacts will be similar for both alternatives. Property impacts will be similar for both alternatives since the city will be implementing a 30-meter right-of-way. Pinewood Park in this section generally has a right-of-way that is greater than 30 meters. There is no known cultural, heritage, or archaeological impacts for either of the alternatives. Hydropole impacts will be the same for both alternatives. The culvert at Cooks Creek has been designed for a 3-lane cross-section. Therefore, either alternative will require an extension of this culvert. The recommended alternative for Pinewood Park Drive is Alternative G. Implementation of Alternative G will prolong the capacity of Pinewood Park Drive, and since the existing right-of-way is already generally greater than 30 meters, there are minimal property impacts to widen the road to 5 lanes. This slide shows the recommended traffic lane configuration for the study area. The extent of the 4-lane cross-section on Lakeshore Drive is shown in orange, and the extent of the 5-lane cross-section on Pinewood Park Drive is shown in blue. The two typical cross-sections on the slide show the city's standard cross-section detail for the recommended 4-lane configuration on Lakeshore Drive and the recommended 5-lane configuration on Pinewood Park Drive. The colored outline on each of the typical sections correspond with the color-coded plan in the previous slide. The existing right-of-way is shown in red on the slide. There are a few locations where properties are required to achieve the minimum right-of-way width of 30 meters. The affected properties have been highlighted in magenta. As you can see from the slide, the property requirements along Pinewood Park Drive are minimal due to the existing 45-meter wide right-of-way. There's one location near Decaire Road where property will be required, and it is shown in magenta. The existing Booth Road intersection is unsignalized and consists of a one-lane approach from all directions. There's a westbound right turn lane from Lakeshore Drive onto Booth and an eastbound slip-by lane along Lakeshore Drive. The future needs for the intersection include improvements to accommodate future traffic volumes, the widening required along Lakeshore Drive, and the upgrades to the entrance for the future community and recreation center. Alternatives have been developed for the intersection and will be shown in greater detail later in the presentation. The existing Riverbend Road intersection is unsignalized and consists of a one through lane in all directions. There are no left or right turn lanes at this intersection. There are no improvements recommended for this intersection based on the traffic impact study. Widening of Lakeshore Drive will improve the operation of the intersection. No alternatives have been developed for this intersection. The existing intersection at Lamorey Street, Lakeshore Drive, Pinewood Park Drive, and Highway 11 ramps is a signalized intersection that is located very close to the southbound Highway 11 off-ramps. Future needs for this intersection include improvements to accommodate the future traffic demands and to address the queuing onto the southbound Highway 11 off-ramp. Alternative solutions have been developed for this intersection and are presented later in the presentation. The existing Decaire Road intersection is an unsignalized intersection with one through lane in all directions. There are no left or right turn lanes at this intersection. There are no improvements that were recommended through the traffic impact study. Widening of Pinewood Park will improve the operations of this intersection. No alternatives were developed for the intersection. Alternative A is to implement a signalized intersection with left turn lanes on both Lakeshore Drive approaches. The sports complex and future community and recreational center entrance have been realigned to match Booth Road to provide a safer intersection. Sidewalks and multi-use trail have been provided along with pedestrian crossings on every leg of the intersection. Bike lanes from Booth Road will cross Lakeshore Drive at the intersection and continue towards Cape Pace Way on the multi-use trail on the south side of Lakeshore Drive. Alternative B is a roundabout control intersection with two through lanes along Lakeshore Drive. Again, the future community recreational center and sports complex entrance has been realigned to match the Booth Road intersection. The multi-use trail has been maintained on the south side of Lakeshore Drive. Bikes using the bike lanes along Booth Road will cross Lakeshore Drive using the shared use in boulevard facilities shown on the roundabout layout. Alternative A and B have been assessed based on the five criteria shown on the left side of the table. Some key items for both alternatives are: Alternative B provides a better level of service for a longer period of time than Alternative A. We do not foresee any major impacts to the natural environment for either alternative. Alternative B requires a slightly more property than Alternative A. However, through design alternatives, those property impacts can likely be reduced. There is no foreseen cultural or heritage impacts with either alternative. And both alternatives allow for the necessary reconstruction of the entrance to the sports complex and the future community and recreation center. Based on the above evaluation criteria, we are recommending that Alternative B, the roundabout, be implemented at this intersection. Alternative A is to implement a signalized intersection. To accommodate traffic demands, a dual left turn from the Highway 11 approach onto Pinewood Park Drive will be required. All other approaches will have a single left turn lane. The existing channelized right turn will remain from Lakeshore Drive onto Pinewood Park Drive. There are some property impacts associated with improving the intersection which have been shown on the plan in magenta. The bike lane infrastructure through the intersection has not been shown on this plan, but will be developed during the design alternatives phase of the EA. Alternative B is to implement a roundabout at the intersection. The roundabout will provide a left through from the east and north approaches, a left through from the west approach, and a signalized right from the Lakeshore Drive onto Pinewood Park Drive. A cul-de-sac will be used to provide access to the properties located at the southwest quadrant of the intersection. There will be more property impacts associated with Alternative B compared to Alternative A. This is mainly due to the cul-de-sac requirements. Property impacts have been shown on the plan in magenta. Bike lane infrastructure has not been shown on this plan, but will be developed later in the EA process. Alternatives A and B have been assessed based on the criteria shown in the table. Some key items that have been highlighted through the evaluation are: for adequate traffic capacity for the Alternative A, a dual left will need to be implemented. Due to the short separation distance between the southbound off-ramps and the intersection, a dual left will not function well. A roundabout will help in this area due to the free flow nature. The roundabout will also help queuing that occurs at the southbound off-ramp. We do not foresee any major impacts to the natural environment for either alternative. The property requirements for Alternative B will be greater than Alternative A. Through design alternatives, the location of the roundabout can be optimized and ways to reduce the property impacts will be investigated. There is no foreseen cultural or heritage impacts with either alternative. The roundabout will be slightly more expensive to construct. However, the roundabout provides a longer-term solution at the intersection. Based on the evaluation criteria, we are recommending that Alternative B, the roundabout, be implemented at the intersection. The typical cross-section shown on the slide depict the various active transportation alternatives for Lakeshore Drive. The first cross-section shows sidewalk on the north side and multi-use trail on the south side of the road. The second cross-section shows sidewalks and bike lanes on both sides of the road. And the third cross-section has sidewalks on both sides, but no bike lanes and no multi-use trail. The typical cross-sections presented on the slide show the various active transportation alternatives for Pinewood Park Drive. The first cross-section shows sidewalks located on both sides of the road. The second cross-section has sidewalks along with on-road bike lanes in each direction. Three active transportation infrastructure alternatives have been developed for the study area. The first option is shown on the slide. From Booth Road east to the Cape Pace Way, there's a sidewalk on the north side of Lakeshore Drive and a multi-use trail on the south side. From the Cape Pace Way east towards Pinewood Park Drive, there will only be concrete sidewalk on both sides of Lakeshore Drive. Heading south on Pinewood Park Drive, there will only be concrete sidewalks on both sides of the road. The colors shown in each section of the study area coincide with the colors outlining the typical cross-section shown on the previous two slides. Option 2 has sidewalks on the north side and multi-use trail on the south side along Lakeshore Drive from Booth Road to the Cape Paceway. East of the Cape Paceway, there will be on-road bike lanes and concrete sidewalks in each direction. Along Pinewood Park Drive, there will be on-road bike lanes and sidewalks in each direction. There will also be cycling infrastructure required at the Highway 11 intersection to tie the bike lanes on Lakeshore Drive and Pinewood Park Drive together. The third option is to have no multi-use trail on Lakeshore Drive and just on-road bike lanes and concrete sidewalks in both directions from Booth Road east to the Highway 11 intersection. Like option 2, Pinewood Park Drive will have on-road bike lanes as well as concrete sidewalks in both directions. Like option 2, cycling infrastructure at the Highway 11 intersection will still be required. The next steps in the Class EA will be to review and address stakeholder comments that are received following this PIC. Once we have factored in the stakeholder comments, we will select the preferred solution for the road widening and intersection improvements. We will develop these solutions further to detail the implementation. There will be a second public information center. After the second public information center presentation, we will prepare the final report, which will be available for public review and comment for 30 days. Finally, we will prepare the notice of study completion. Please direct any comments to the consultant whose email is located at the bottom of the slide. Thank you for your interest, and we look forward to hearing from you.